Chelsea Bell has been in touch to ask us how to paint the stags of the Sisters of the Thorn. So in this video, we're going to show you how to paint that blue and white fur pattern. And to do it, what you need to do is undercut your stag using Corax White, and then you need to start out with Rust Grey to block in all the areas of the blue fur. After that, we're going to add some shade to those parts using Norn Oil, and then we're going to turn to the white parts of the fur, starting out with a shade of Seraphim Sepia, and then a layer of Pallid Witch Flesh before we finish that part with a highlight of White Scar. Then we're going to go back to that blue fur to finish it off with Fenrisian Grey. But we're going to start out with Rust Grey, and I'm going to apply this using my medium layer brush. And with this colour, when you get it on your palette, you want to thin it down a little bit more than you normally would. You're looking for about this, well, a little bit more than that, I think. About this sort of consistency before you start to apply it. And what you want to do is just put this onto all the areas that you want to be blue. So the kind of things we're looking at here are the legs towards the hooves, so just down here. And when you apply this part on, just be sure to paint it in lines going down the leg like that, so you get a soft transition there. We'll build on later on as we go from the blue to the lighter parts. But you also want to paint all this hair around the neck, and also a pattern on the forehead, of which you can make as detailed as you like. Once we've finished blocking in that blue, we're now ready to add some depth to it and darken it down by applying a coat of Norn Oil all over it, except for one part of the blue in particular. Now that's on the legs. On these parts, what you want to do is just avoid the area where the blue meets the white. Just go a little distance down and apply it down there like that. Now if you want some areas to be darker, let this coat of Norn Oil dry, then apply a second coat in the same way, just focusing it more on the areas that you want to be darker. But the choice about that is up to you. We're going to leave the blue fur for now and start painting in details on the white fur. For this, we're going to start with Seraphim Sepia, applied as a recessed shade with a small layer brush. You want to follow all the recessed details all across the white parts of the body to give these areas some more depth. Once that shade's completely dry, we're now going to start neatening it up by applying a layer of Pallid Witch Flesh with a medium layer brush. And what you want to do is paint this over all the white areas of the fur, just leaving the recesses with that shade still showing, just the very deepest areas, like this. Now the only area you need to really be careful on is when you get close to the legs here. When you meet the blue, what you want to do is, once again like before, just paint it in lines going down onto them there like that. Now we're ready to start highlighting, beginning with White Scar for all the white areas of the fur. And for this, what you want to do is just pick out all the most defined features, such as these ones, for example, on the face. And finally, we just need to highlight all the blue fur by using Fenrisian Grey and lightly dry brushing it. Now, if you want a little bit more control on the blue areas just on the forehead, instead of what you can do is do a line highlight on there using the same technique we did previously with the white, but of course still using Fenrisian Grey. And here we are, the vast majority of this stag is now completed in that Sisters of the Thorn colour scheme. All it needs are those remaining small details to be painted in. So Chelsea, I really hope that helps you out, and we'll see you all again soon.